So, welcome everyone, all the new subscribers and everyone, friends and family here to another live stream. Some live in-depth work here, Linux stuff. Live stream, there's even my QEMU. So I was testing the latest build here of Musl stuff, spent way too much time as usual on this stuff because as usual nothing really, well, not nothing, but a lot of stuff didn't really work. And I don't welcome Devi and everyone else. So I will not go through here. This stream will become long enough because, first of all, I had to go through all the Musl stuff, still the Musl ceiling stuff, the more alternative stuff and what everything is broken also. Yeah, so I created an ISO, but we have still quite some errors. Also, I spent here way too many hours fixing or plumbing, working, workarounding, hot fixing stuff. Still quite some stuff to do, and right now I just want to get the bare minimum system out there because I finally want to get done with this, and probably theoretically it could be another monster 6-hour live stream. Also, yeah, also dialogue was broken, so this is actually already the third ISO also I built, and there you see how much time and stuff and motivation and everything goes into there. Dialog did not even work, and there even for some reason LS also is behaving erratically also, not without it, whatever is with LS, actually not sure if which whatever LS it is, Amputus or whatever, but that is not even the main point. So another monster live stream, and fun fact, maybe if the copyright claims of Apple's bloody stupid failed live stream there on the secondary More Life channel goes away, hopefully eventually, and we can live stream there again, because this kind of stuff would be more topic of this More Live Stream stuff. And welcome Christian, and because then theoretically we could even on the More Live channel have the 24/7 running straight from some frame buffer build server building T2 the whole day and fun stuff. Questions in the audience, mechanical keyboards. Guess, so you brought a mechanical, but you said you didn't like them so much. Yesterday you said you like, you said you like membrane keyboards. You don't tell me you brought a mechanical keyboard today. I also have some news for that, but that's probably for another live stream. So which mechanical or membrane keyboard did you purchase today? So getting back to the work, I just realized, so you compile here all the stuff, and only then you realize, wait a second, all this stuff doesn't even work, change root does nothing whatsoever, figured not even the bloody C library is in there. So here, professional stuff for 100. I fixed here even mputils and ipconfig, totally small embedded util stuff that we use for the initrd and installer stuff, and then even my system library didn't even build. And that is the first thing. So probably we could sit here 6 hours and go here through all this stuff and fix to build this. But this is maybe for another live stream, maybe on whatever channel. So why does the Musl C library not build? Well, actually it built weeks or months ago. Actually not really sure why it didn't build right now. Let's take a look together. Actually, fun fact, what is this package config? That is var log package config. Why does it, or is it, oh, this is cross build, whatever. Yeah, so this build is a little bit messy because this is a build from a month ago or so, plus rebuilds and whatsoever, and an LVM ceiling update. So totally not clean, totally not how you should be doing this, but I eventually wanted to get a test build out. Also not only for my own archiving, but also to for you to play it along at home. Also fun fact, Mesa didn't build here with some XML, wait a second. Here with some XML something, XML pool options, H file not found. I never had this error, so that is also not really sure if that is Musl ceiling related. However, fun fact, if you Google this, you get a couple of hits, so just not making up that all the stuff usually breaks and doesn't work. But first, we anyway need a Musl libc, and as soon as we have the most minimal ISO working, and I can show you how Z-Works, that would look like this. So this is then, if this built through, so this all this red stuff are errors, kind of warning, kind of all stuff missing. As you see, Python, RiserFS, ZXK, BMap, and all this S-Trace fun stuff, all this stuff that might or might not build with some quirks, but that we could get away with just leaving out there. And the most important thing, I hope, is just the musl. Well, actually, I thought an hour ago I'm done until I noticed, wait a second, why is the C library missing there? So all those stuff is missing for now, RiserFS procs and whatsoever, S-Trace, nice stuff to have, but not vital. And T2 would still create the ISO image, right? So you can ignore this and just try to install it like I did, but then yeah, quite some stuff missing. Let's see, comments as audience. Christian still needs to tell us which mechanical keyboard he built, purchased. So this is stuff actually. So this are helper functions or runtime functions, as this is an educational channel here. You are here to learn stuff. So this are multiply, and even I don't quite know, I would need to Google this now, what precisely. So this could be some 128-bit or the reminder or whatever. So because x86 CPUs couldn't, what maybe. So for some stuff is of course native to the instruction set, and some not, and whatever that is. So compiler RT new, here we probably should be able to see what this is. Or this could also be complex or something. So this is multiply. So on x86 32-bit, you have more of those helper functions, for example, for, I don't know, I would guesstimate 64-bit multiplications, divisions, or 128-bit and all this fun stuff. And as you see, also complex multiplication and such stuff. So this should be in compiler RT, and I actually don't really quite remember how I quirked this the last time. This is all the manual stuff that I meant. A lot of this stuff already sorted into T2. You could take a look at this fun stuff here, changelog, and go through there or just poke around there. You see even today, probably the 17th, right, PCI Euclid's Xterm, some updates. This is not even all, this will be generating later. So I've like totally don't even remember late at some midnight some months ago what I did with this. We could for a quick test see. So first, maybe we just link this in there. I think this is probably, it needs to be in the C library, maybe from the static archive. And just when we take a look, comments in the audience, exactly, Christian writes, it makes no sense, some Razer bullshit with RGB, either cheap, something keyboard that I know from experience will break in some weeks, one of those, I need a keyboard now. Sorry for my bad influence there. And yeah, also updates to that, probably to this text, whatever. So yeah, first figure out, you could object dump or NM or whatever, or LLVM, whatsoever, something, but we can just use grep usually for that. So that is our sandbox. And then let's just grep maybe this here. And maybe actually, I guess one of those builds, I even commented those functions out. Actually, maybe that is what I did. Let's see, maybe I have here a musl, hex patch cross. Let's see, something uncommitted. Hex patch cross. Wait a second. So this actually, you see, I made you something completely dirty. So sometimes I'm completely evil and like totally not how you're doing it. And as you see, I just wanted this stuff to build, and I just, so this is, yeah, complex. This is probably where this was generated. I probably object dumped that and took a look which function or whatever. And there, yeah. So for cross builds to get this stuff, the build going, like totally, like, yeah, not interested in this esoteric function that like 0.00000001% of the packages ever got to use. And I commented this out. Okay, so now I remember actually this grave hack. This might be before or after we package this. So then let's build this again with job musel. And actually the build is slightly slowed down because we are building this. This is an amazing Ryzen build from last year, still waiting for the 16 core 32 thread SKU. And this is only 8 threads or cores passed down, so half the threads because it is a VM. So then you have seen this probably before already going in here. By the way, I should by the way check the scene here. It's actually not too bad. And then so the question actually is how this usually works. Trial it, so configure tests. Okay, so this might actually be a configure test. So I'm guessing here, I can't also know each and every thing here, but I guess this usually probably should be in libgcc, I guess, exactly what we don't have here. Actually, so fun fact, if you build with Clang on an otherwise GCC native system, Clang or Clang will just use GCC libgcc, right? Because this is your system ABI. This is only, so if you build with Clang, Clang LVM, you will not have this problem on your regular system at home. Only if you take GCC out of the equation, because we want to get rid of this here for test build. Only because of this, we have this more esoteric setup here. And as you probably realize in the meantime, we totally love esoteric systems. So libgcc is only in there though. Libgcc with draft unwind support, possibly other low level tools. Maybe we, let's read what is here. What have they written here? Add ucontext, ccontext support and headers. Libgcc with Dwarf 2 unwinding support and possibly other low level tools. Not really too much more information. Actually, did I? Hello, why does it? Probably mistyped. Probably recursive, so maybe here we have tools. So static libc, okay, I guess then usually this builds with. So I'm only guessing, you could read the whole source, but usually a little bit shortcut, just the first grab and guessing here, because I again, we could, you have seen this KDE GNOME, otherwise it takes six hours anyway. So static libgcc, that probably means we can somehow hackily inject our compiler runtime. Do we get the same error running that? Yeah, we get. Ah, right, actually, so the this is how I commented this all. I didn't even have to run object dump, the compiler or linker. Probably the linker already tells you which amazing functions it is in. Now we only need to find out which of the compiler RT stuff. Also, yeah, this typing slightly delayed. This is going here across Europe, because why not? User, that is what we have clouds for. So that's going to my cloud. And just what we have SSH for, Clang something. Okay, it is not there on the first glance. Ah, here is something. So libclang rt, the question is, how do we inject this? We could, by the way, object dump this with object dump disassembly, should be something like that, I guess. Yeah, exactly like that. And then what was it even, that was some diff or mool or whatever. Oh, it's already, are you kidding me, it's the first one already. Yeah, this is how it's handled internally, some fine SSE or whatever registers here, complex division. So I wonder slightly, will Clang find this by itself, or what would we, actually it does here libgcc. That is interesting, just not doing something with that, or could also, whatever, user Actually, the fastest is find is super slow. With T2, we have the comfort of just grep over lower IDMF list. I slightly wonder, so this LGCC is maybe totally ignored, or we transform this away with our amazing T2 tools. No, we don't, at least not according to this log. Could of course also check always for comments in the audience. Have you seen the latest and greatest Threadripper things monster jutting from the benchmarks? Yeah, seen the benchmarks, still waiting for AMD volunteering to donate or loan or provide one. That is probably a little bit... Do we have so much? Oh, this is screen scrollback, so... Yeah, seen the Threadripper, for me, cheapskate, it is enough. How do we get this in there now? To get the 32, which directory is it? It's in lib. Is this coming from this makefile? No, it's not coming from this makefile. Oh, wait a second, so lib. Ah, here we have that. So we could, for a quick test, hard code this, maybe. So yeah, I've seen the Threadripper to finish that sort. Just a little bit too expensive for us, but if you share, like, and subscribe enough, did I say below some other video already, if it gets 1000 likes, we buy one. But the more the channel grows, the more, of course, we get such amazing hardware. But first is the next 3950X. So where was this? What did I use? Grep, right? Or find or grep, or... I slightly wonder that ceiling clang ignores this libgcc. Actually, we could... wait a second, we could actually stress this lock and maybe open or stud and less lock and see if it does anything with libgcc. No, it totally ignores it somewhere. That is interesting. Yeah, that is the fun stuff where you always waste an hour or two here and there, stuff that's not just working. By the way, did I... Oh, okay, maybe we set this to, let's do this with follow forks. Yeah, probably also should. Yeah, another day. Why is this so slow? Is this so slow with stress or what? Don't have so much time though. Libgcc. Ah, there it's actually doing something. Oh, it's using the shared library. Oh, interesting. Or did it not use static libgcc? This might be a symlink. So this are all this manual. Oh, this is to lib unbind. Yeah, so it could be that in libgcc there is multiple stuff. These are this kind of shortcuts that I mentioned. Symlinking, there's some stuff because packages expected somewhere in lib unwind, whatever. So this is unwinding for also including stack and exception handling. And then with the compiler RT that is more separated. Let's grab this here once more. That was div. And so this kind of hexes are only temporary. This is another day. We need to spend another afternoon or night and figure out all how to really do it. What did I even do here? Find, or did I not grab this? Or I probably did that. So built-ins and profile. I think, what did we object dump? We object dump something. We object dump this built-ins. So let's maybe put this here to LGCC and see what happens. Just like that could maybe work. But it doesn't. Libgcc, it's here though. It's only used here in this one makefile, though. Or we just supply, let's double check here with... I have here in with the scripts in develop ceiling of course parse config. Do I? No, I don't. But so we have here already, if then we have here compiler RT, we could give that a try. That is getting familiar with the compiler, and then it's sometimes, you could always read the fucking manual in source, but that is sometimes a little bit excessive. Also slightly wonder, maybe it doesn't have effect there for one reason or another. So you see it's not appearing there, so whatever it says. Also, yeah, build systems, even with this old-fashioned stuff, you think you know them, but then they don't do what you wanted it to do. It was somehow libcc, right? Why would that not work? No standard lib. I mean, we could actually try to hard code there. No idea why this doesn't have any. Oops. Nah. It's a little bit annoying that each tool and each compiler has its own stuff and you need to relearn and get familiar again. Actually, wait a second. It has here also static lib though, but it's a little bit, maybe I should have placed it at the end here. Is it not? What is it even trying to link? Not enough scrollback or what? Here that comes from. No, we have more scrollback. Just whatever was wrong with it. Yeah, also modern. Oh no, we don't have enough scrollback. Nah. Fun stuff. No, that was the wrong order. Sometimes you need that, or sometimes the other. No, that works. Shared. So not standard lib shared, all this stuff. By the way, somehow the ThinkPad gets a little bit warm. Are we doing okay? Zero drop frames. Dynamic list, no standard lib shared, all this stuff. Ah, here, but we have compiler RT just, no, we have it there, whatever, so that is doing nothing. So somehow it doesn't work. Why does it not work, or does it only should have all, or does it only, oh, but here we also have a space, strange, make file stuff. So, oh, wait a second, didn't want compiler RT. That didn't do much. Built-ins, let's see what happens. Is it linked? Yep. So, it's a little bit dirty, obviously. Probably I need to grab then the whole ceiling source. The problem is we are so much on the forefront of technology here and latest and greatest stuff, that that you don't find so many stuff. And besides, if I spend 15 minutes googling it on the internet, I can also just do it myself. So fix file, it's our own helper, and let's fix file. So this actually, so this is a little bit of a hack. Normally you would edit this file. This is a little bit of my internal, because I didn't use it there directly. So built in would be that, so I use it in reverse order a little bit. Non-standard. So yeah, this gives that result. This is of course only working for x86. First, I want the most proof of concept and then later we can make this pretty. Also, this is why it's not committed, but let me first fix file hot hack. So hottest fix is not hot fix, but hot hack if it's totally, then I have a little bit funny professional names here. Patch, of course, only for Musl. And just proof of concept to see if, wait a second, we want it, just to see if it works. And because it makes no sense to already, first of all, this kind of hot hacks I don't commit, except if it's at least halfway decent. Also that didn't, wait a second, we have already some hot hacks there, apparently. Oh, what did I do there now? Why is this? Ah, we have hot hack on, no, we have, hold on, what have I done here now? Because the patch didn't apply, why not? Why is this twice? Hot hack patch Musl, what the heck? Can't make that up, what have I done now? I mean, maybe, okay, maybe this hex I leave there for now, it's not committed anyway. Don't quite understand why we have this applied twice. Certainly only in here once. Nah, someone not my daemon, not even the... This I also have Rally. Maybe it could be a bug, but I didn't really hit this yet. Also, yeah, this warning we also probably want to fix another live stream. So much stuff to fix and do. Because this could be... I have custom code to... patch files, where would that be? I have custom code to add this Musl patches with the Musl extension. Club only deer. Patch file set. Here it's two times in there. Why is it two times in there? Can't make that up. This is hilarious. Maybe is this here in parse config? Maybe we match here on Musl and patch files if conftier. So if echo that directory, does if this expanded appending Musl patches. What? Why did it not work? Anyway, guess for some later minutes. Actually, maybe I should really try to get this Musl append patches. Why would this not work? Why did I not use ls? But anyway, how can this not work? Var append patch files. We use shell scripting because it's readable, and then you don't even understand shell script. Actually, we could, there should be maybe in the extras there. So patch files starts with that saved patch file Z. It's already in there. Patch Musl for Tarball. And then there is ls though. Build this package line 860. Build Z this patch. Maybe because it's package.package extension or some. Which line was it even? Should have. You know what? Maybe we do this slightly later. Build this package H859. Saved patch files. We have some if you build multiple patch files. Okay. Because this matches to the patch files and some feature conflict. Musilipsy versus is a little bit inconvenient. Features over features. At least we now understand why this happens. Anyway, then let's rename this without that. It doesn't matter for now. Let's try to rebuild it again. And then what if you see so no new comment in the audience. We could actually also enable verbose again for the best matrix effect. Config user config. Okay, that build. I slightly wonder, does it also work? Probably some change root should maybe confirm this in user. Still works, I guess. Yeah, so this is a little bit, still a little bit, yeah, there you see one esoteric thing there. And beside, I don't even like the compiler RT placement of the file. It shouldn't be in lib, a little bit strange there. But that is where I think compiler RT installs itself there. So a couple of those build errors could go away now because I saw at least one more of those divide something errors. And as this built-in stuff is now linked into the standard libc, which I hope is the right way to do this, var adm log. So div something in error. Yeah, so this is at least you see SmartMon tools surprisingly, and maybe only SmartMon tools. Anyway, let's maybe delete most of this error logs of stage 5. Oops, that's not really what I exactly wanted. I wanted verbose ask something because I didn't really want to build ceiling. Okay, that ceiling build and LVM. That build too, okay. But I don't really want to build. Most of the stuff will still not build. Did I Linux? Okay, this build. Yeah, not sure how much more will build now. But I shortly, so we deleted log files. So this will try to rebuild all the packages. Maybe many of this will still fail, but you can watch this failing if you want. But that, hey, that built successfully. I hope I only delete the errors, right, for whatever reason. Anyway, yeah, you can see the matrix scrolling by while I go for a quick dinner. So enjoy the matrix. And oops, also I wanted this. And see you in a bit. So, one quick dinner at home later. Welcome back. 11 people or so watching The Matrix, scrolling by, amazing stuff. And other people need to do the dishes, that is also good. And so I don't really expect too much more stuff of this stuff to build anyway. We can probably pause this or whatever. Let's actually run this build target thing that rebuilds me, exactly what I don't want. Then let's, yeah, okay, maybe this is a little error now, is it? Damn, RV, we removed this. That was not very clever of me. How many of those are there left? Error list. How many to go? 20 to go. Super clever for me. And then let's maybe, well, many of them. What is this here? Can't read so fast. Yeah, so usually I don't let the matrix scroll by here. That is, of course, mostly for the YouTube effect here. Also, what do you think about the idea? Maybe, well, 8, 11 people continued watching here. Amazing stuff. And maybe for the second channel, I could do this even from the data center server, basically all day long. Maybe would be theoretically like modern replacement of IRC channel of people getting together and asking the Linux questions. But that's some setup for another day or week. Yeah, shortly waiting. This is only because I removed the error files. Actually, I probably should not have eaten them so fast, but whatever now. I also, so this is actually, by the way, using link time optimization where all the compiler compiler invocations do not directly produce the machine object files, but the intermediate bit, how do they call it? Bit stream, call it bit stream, bit format, how do they call it? Call it Lua. Lua it is. Damn, do I get too old here? Oh, wait a second, there was even a failed patch. So some of those stuff, so many of this stuff is failing because of some GNUism or otherwise hard coding of whatever. And other stuff, what is this, X2FS, whatever. Yeah, actually we can, of course we have screen, let's switch, or let's failed in build musl 9 what logs error. Okay, CDR could do some old stuff anyway. Yeah, also 2019, you still probably, I've already 20 times in my life hacked lib lstiff to build and yes, for example, this is, I wonder what is the error, and so this is for NFS, which also failed then, obviously, because it's a dependency for that. What would that be? Ah, this Q file not found, yeah, GNUisms or whatever. Actually don't really see, or does it stop compiling? I wonder if it stops compiling immediately. Or if we would be lucky and it would build if we just remove that. Actually, we could maybe give that a try. Because sometimes I just include stuff. Sometimes we are so super lucky. Lib tier PC something. Oops, what was that? Also not on. So that is in source broadcast, but maybe the compiler just stopped instantly, didn't really continue following this clutched support for simple RPC. Hmm. Yeah, of course it didn't build, so okay, the C-linked instantly stopped. So this queue, we probably don't have this here, user include this. Yeah, as in probably no NFS for now. Rarely used it the last decade anyway. Still wondering about the failed patch though. This might be a low-hanging fruit. What was the error message though? Here, reject file e2fs procs. Okay, so instead file system e2fs procs. Nothing to commit. Okay, we probably have some musel. Yeah, okay, we have some hotfix for musel. That certainly doesn't. Oh, some cast. Yeah, so you see, this is really stupid typing. Who should even. Why they ever use this is beyond me. But yeah, bytecode. Did I say bytecode? Bitcode, yeah. Probably my. Body is busy processing food now. So let's try to remove this and let's try if we are so lucky if this builds. Yeah, also this underscore underscore uint64 probably should have never used. But whatever. Damn it. Another, yeah, I also need. So we have the glibc in T2 because we historically installed quite some large packages in opt. We have support for wildcards in ldconf for glibc. I need to port this to musel. So even in glibc, you also need to put all this stuff like opt chrome, whatever, in ldconf something, at least the last time I checked. And for a decade, we have support for wildcards there. So that is, should have really known better. This is why I didn't really plan to rebuild. I had manually edited this so much to some manual edits here to just for, oops, because we have this GNOME stuff including glib there, although nowadays glib used for everything, but whatever. Oops, nah, how did that happen? Sloppy typing for 200, so let's, what is it, etfs procs. Yeah, you see even DHCP, but this DHCP package maybe not the most preferred anyway because it's super large. This ISC something, and maybe even one of those even included the full bind sources. Not sure if it also the NTP package super large. Yeah, and this is why usually you should send this stuff upstream because if you don't, then it doesn't apply eventually any more anyway, and if you send it upstream you get the famous contribution author marks there, so yeah, should have done that, but whatever. So here, remove it. Also, we can, by the way, fun fact, check if there is a new version, but apparently not. So here, then let's finish this. There should not be, but yeah, at least, so you see the next package fixed. That was a totally easy one. And you, of course, totally welcome to package your stuff here. Use it for ARM, MIPS, embedded stuff, GNOME, any help. Highly appreciated. Yeah, if you want to update something, work on this, you see if a lot of stuff you could clean up if you're looking for inspiration or some Janitor work, getting into open source and stuff. Hey, Mesa demos failed. That is interesting. That not failed, succeeded. Because Mesa failed earlier, but it could be. Yeah, Mesa failed, but it could be we have. Actually, but maybe I killed it. So let's with Control C, let's give that one more shot. Because I think Mesa built before, but you see a random. This is my grief here and recurring theme with random changes, and that it built last month doesn't mean that it built this month. Yeah, 2000 something source files, you name it. Again, the Ryzen build would be two times faster if I would, or nearly two times faster if I would pass all the threads down there. But yeah, let's see. But this is probably the really last package, and then we try to run it. Actually, I still have it running here. I can close this already. You have seen that didn't work. And even so, then we have the muselibc in there and the Mesa demos. And so if you want stuff to do, I totally welcome. And you could build one of those, hack there on ceiling, musel stuff and send the stuff upstream and make everything better. Certainly in any case, maybe next year we have an even more high performance compiler and then all the stuff is already de-GNUed, de-GCC'd or un-GCC'd, instead of un-Googled, un-GNUed. Hello, are we compiling here or seriously so long? But I'm not sure, do I have, maybe I have, yeah, also you see this day and age and that takes here 1 minute to run. Actually, I wonder slightly. Sometimes they have super large files, like generated stuff, tables for 3D stuff and so on. So that is, there's even our, change route, build time, where's even our grab ceiling? Oh, there's something maybe just in that second. No, not in that second. Here is some, so yeah, gen perf matrix. Mm-hmm. So maybe generated performance matrix. Apparently, maybe. Could actually, as we have nothing better to do here live on YouTube. Meson generated. Oh, yeah, that, oh, wait a second, that is our object file. Is it even, oh, okay, that failed, not anyway. Just went away in that second after compiling so long, but, what is the error? Probably still this XML, yeah, XML pool. If you know, if you want to Google this, help me out here. Google XML pool options HI. Googled this already. This was already an old bug in 2013 that I think was closed there. So whatever reason, and this was also an autoconf automake. So apparently, there you see amazing new build systems. Now we built with Mason and Ninja, and we get old bugs back that were fixed already decades ago, but yeah. So let's, so this will just create here some text files, some text meta database stuff, like packages, and they also build this second stage installer. This removing is intentionally, this is a P3 work to make this smaller. So finished now, and then ISO. And then I should probably actually not type, I should actually, ah, that is bright. Go away, brother. Why are you so white? Should actually maybe have a internal host name, because I shouldn't leak this IPv6 address here. Now everyone is waiting for me to leak it. So rsyncing this here. And fun fact, this IPv6 address is earlier because as until recently it didn't really have too much IPv6 support and didn't just work. SCP, rsync didn't grok IPv6 addresses, and you need to put this in square brackets. That is a little bit annoying if you don't have a hostname. So yeah, QEMU, enable KVM, all this fun stuff here. And boot this. So this is next thing we also need to change this to EFI. This is for my convenience reasons. The old-fashioned MBR boot stuff, because I would just want to get this stuff going. And so this is my previous installation. So just mount this existing file system here and install. Oh wait, okay, let's see what happens, because I'm not sure. And yeah, some warnings. Oh wait a second, how is, need to check. Oh, no, damn, it was only live on YouTube. Using my own installer wrong. Extras I wanted. How is install all in tree? Is E maybe? Oh, no, okay. That is only the ones that are new. Let's see what's doing here. Handful. Okay, it still didn't work. I have the feeling. Change root. Empty target. Yeah, that's not doing much, unfortunately. Can't make this up so much here. You build some new fancy stuff, musel, ceiling also, you probably want some light, right? You build the latest and greatest and then it doesn't even work. The last time for the, I said I have this already in operation, the previous hacked build, there I just rsync the whole sandbox and didn't even go through the install cycle here. I also wonder why ls doesn't work anyway. Find, yes, it's quite some files. Why would this still not? Maybe we run. Super clever to really do this. At least it's medium fast. Why do I use find? Because ls somehow doesn't work here. So find bin bash that we have, then. Let's try to run user lib c so. We have the two that also works, and then user or bin bash. F. Wait a second. Ld. We have this. Why? Did I ever had that issue? Wait a second, lib unwind SEO. Doesn't even find lib unwind SEO. Which we really don't have. Maybe that failed for some reason. Hello, lib unwind. Why is there no lib unwind? Maybe because I didn't enable it. All right, I recently changed the defaults because it was too annoying. I didn't want to have them in all the regular builds. That was a totally clever move. Which other would that be? Compiler RT? Oh, wait a second, we better check with grep lib unwind config musel packages. Yes, that's not enabled. But the others are, I think, compiler RT. No, compiler RT also not. Yeah, I changed this. What is this lib standard? Also not. Oh, wait a second, that is the wrong one. Lib, oh, I think it's lib cxx. Yeah, okay, fine. So then that, and that. We need enabled, wait a second, from here to there. This is just because it's not a standard build, right? So the generic build is still defaulting to GNU stuff. This is why we don't have it here. I probably have manually tweaked here something for whatever. Yeah, here is this in 0.0 Bootstrap. I'm still not really sure if we want more people to use this. I probably need to make a nice config option because I certainly can't expect everyone to go through the hops here and figure all the packages out themselves. So probably that maybe we need a global option. Oh, wait a second, that is wrong. Global option whether to use. The problem is that these are so many combinations, right? So you can use glibc. Well, okay, you cannot yet, but maybe eventually you will be able to use also from there glibc another day in the future, sometime soon or so. The ceiling right now not, because GNU features. And then there are really many combinations, because it's like glibc with which compiler, and then it's also the, yeah, if whether you have GCC. If you don't have GCC, then you need all this alternative, this is libstandard C++, but also libstandard C++ ABI and compiler RT with all the other compiler runtime stuff, like this divide, multiply, lib unwind. Also, this was wrong because only live on YouTube. We need here the right config muse. And yeah, anyway, I hope you learned something, find this interesting. At least we have some people watching. That is, as usual, quite amazing. And then let's build this. It hopefully should maybe build one package or another. And then we are doing that again. Let's see. Let's hope they even build all, which of course they don't. But okay, we can ignore this. This is cross-compile and bootstrapping this. I don't care. Only the native version needs to build, which it also didn't. Because why should it? Fun stuff. Only here live on YouTube, all the bits and pieces. The lib unwind we needed for that, but we need the other libraries. So this is also testing the latest and greatest code, right? This is, they also made some upstream changes. Hey, lib unwind at least compiled. And compiler RT. Are we so lucky that this also builds? Maybe? No. Maybe theoretically we probably, hey, here did something is linking though. Ah, this could also not build. I'm building this LTO. Hey, libcxx. Actually, wait a second. I thought we built this already. Core dumped? Not cool. Okay, at least this is still working. The problem is with updating this stuff. I said yesterday I ruined the other virtual machine. So compiler RT, it could also be libLTO though, link time optimization. Let's see, here is something. Fuzzer, is it fuzzer? Sanitizer. It could be that this sanitizer, which of even, yeah, F is tab. Actually, I, okay, so this is compiler RT. This I have a quick fix for, because sanitizer, I sort, we disabled this already. Sanitizer. Here is sanitizer. If cross, actually I thought we disabled this already here. If clip, if libc is musel, then This should be disabled. Apparently fun stuff that doesn't work. Yeah, it's running with sanitizers off. Apparently, yeah, there you see why do I have this grief with Manson or whatever and stuff and CMake, yeah. If everything would at least use autoconfig make files, which we have done 20 years ago at least, we would know where to look now. Now we need to check what is wrong with it. Does CMake something sanitize build sanitizers? Yes, by the way, RT, wait a second. Why is this in? This is a compiler. Was it? Yeah, so here you see the CRT begin, CRT end stuff just new. Compiler RT build sanitizers. Did say change compiler RT build? Looks like that though. Can't make this up in real life on this channel. Mark as advanced. What does that do? Do you need to enable advanced or what? Mark as advanced. What would that be doing? You're kidding me. So we have here advanced property for advanced internal. What the heck? Advanced property for variable internal one. You're kidding me. What does it even mean? But I mean, it has bool off and it's building it anyway. Build sanitizers. Compilerity. Sanitizers to build all? What? I want none. If supported on this target. CXX, what? Allow use of C++ ABI. Sanitizer. Amazing CMake files. Fun stuff. Fix all sanitizers. Maybe comments in the audience. Not really, huh? So a sun, something, whatever. By the way, maybe we can set this to an empty string. Does it work? Maybe. Let's see. Yeah, I find it's a little bit annoying that we need to have so many build systems, a couple of ones. Oh, not a big deal. There's already too many, and each has its own quirks and bugs and features. Yeah, I guess that this package might actually fully build if we would be able to disable the sanitizer stuff and uncaught exception not yet implemented. What? The question is, of course, also always, do we break something with rebuilding this? If something is dynamically using that, or what we have not yet, or have we core dumped? Maybe we have no. Successfully broken. Because it was. Maybe now we have broken this again. Does the compiler still work or. No. Well done. That is not fun stuff. I mean, we did build libunwind though, very theoretically. Let's try a new ISO. Yeah, this is why I wanted to publish this ISO before breaking everything again. That is a little bit, yes, this is also what I found. The LLVM ceiling stuff is much more prone to break because, I mean, first of all, of course, still randomly changing his stuff, but also it's more components, which usually is a good thing, I would say. Some more fine grained, although LLVM certainly is large enough. But being this individual components means also if you build LLVM and then ceiling, then you can't link time optimize anymore because then your LLD is still the old one. So then you first need to build LLD with the new support for the new byte code. And unless, can you build, so probably you build LLVM and then LLD and then, oh, but then you can also, no, you have in any case a chicken egg problem because circular dependency for even in that case, then you still can't link time optimize ceiling, although probably don't want this because it runs 1 hour on this Ryzen, being there, done that. Do I even, okay, so I need to rsync, so 1 second. So that builds the ISO, then can quit the QEMU and rsync. Of course, rsync-arv something capital P for in place and progress, therefore the ISO 2 syncs this here in just some seconds. Then back to that. Again, yeah, probably need a some internal names here in my host file for some otherwise temporary virtual machine stuff, not to leak here IP addresses all over the place. In times of IPv6, certainly not the smartest thing to do. To fit. So, yeah, also, yeah, this I also need to still fine tune again after rewriting half of it still a bit. Yeah. Let's see what happens with this mount. Oops. Mount existing file system there. Install that with that, and that was E, I think. Let's double check, do we have lib unwind? No, we don't. Why does it not? So it was E, was it not E? Yeah, nearly only lib unwind, but why? Okay, we could also, was it not E or was it install all packages in tree? Don't quite get why this doesn't. At least I have not written this. Lip unwind, yeah, no. Shit, Sherlock. That happened. Did work a second ago, thanks God. I have not written the installer, so I can blame someone else now. Oh, maybe caps lock or some other nonsense like that. Probably could really just select it though. Only wonder if there are more like this, maybe not. Yeah, all this. Oh, there was something though. Ah, here we have it. Things are still done. Mount target. Actually does work. Why does this not? Maybe the PD case A, but at least we have some progress now. Don't really quite know why the stone stuff did not change route into that. Maybe dialogue. Debugging your installer live on YouTube. Ah, libcx, next thing, missing message directory, fun stuff. Which does it even? I need it by lib unwind. Can't make this up. Yes, luckily, we just broke off. Just broke our. Don't really quite know what is broken here now, though. What segmentation folded here? Conf test, though. Wait a second, this is only. Let's build here something. Such bad luck. Cordumped CMake. What exactly cordumped there? Is it uncord exception not yet implemented? Wait a second, so this is not a. What have I done to that? It was working a second ago. Yeah, again, exactly why I wanted to publish an ISO image to have some mostly working state here. Exactly the fun stuff that we are here for. I only clean this not to have there 20 source deals and it's always annoying with auto completion. By the way, did I build with extras? Probably not. Actually, here we have something for. Unused during compilation. Actually, this could be undefined reference to. What is it even trying here? This is why we have here in MISC archive some Hello World examples. Yep, that is exactly that. Error adding symbols missing from command line. CXXABI. Yeah, this parse stuff here is also not my invention. I also don't like this here. This is relative to bin, wherever that is coming from, but that is something for another day. Yeah, also lib64, .lib64, like, yeah, the compiler people and their magic. So what do we have here? We have here something, so missing from undefined reference to. Maybe this is because ABI thing and the other are now out of sync. Well, it is defined in here or not. This looks defined. Okay, explicitly adding it fixes that. Okay. I have here, yeah, all the fine details that need to be all right, and you need to figure out and learn how the ones is configured. I actually sort, we built this defaulting to. Wait a second, why is here two times a copyright node? What happened with it? Messed this up, fun stuff. Probably press some random VI key here. Huh? Default. Here is standard lib, is here default CXX standard lib, lib CXX. All the fun stuff that doesn't really work. But I also have here some parse config. Here, so for all. Okay, for all packages, we actually insert this here because it didn't find this. So then I guess we only make this for compiler RT and ABI. Let's see if which of those did not you build? Libcxx. Didn't build, ABI also didn't build, what? Okay, let's first try if we can build CXX like that. Yeah, fun stuff that is a little bit underdocumented and few mere mortals ever have to get in touch with. I have a little bit of the feeling it's maybe scare some regular subscribers away. What time do we have? No, we're actually gained 2 subscribers. Amazing stuff. Also it's a little bit super dry stuff, and this also aborted because something. Let's take a look at the log file. Is it still the same or? Do we inject this? Maybe not. What? What have I done there? libcxxavi, otherwise insert that looks correct, so. It's not compiler RT, not that. Why does this match? Or is this again some, was it that new shells can't have an empty statement here? Fun stuff of shells. Compile order. Why do I even if? Oh, okay, maybe because space. Okay, see. Apparently, nobody has Googled me the other issue, right? CXXAVI, why is this not getting in there? Ah, X-Trace is on. Or does it match with... Does it anyway match? Does minus have some... Maybe we need to quote that. Or do we compiler RT? libcxx. Okay, wait a second. What actually at? I have not a stage toolchain. Looks actually all quite right. I really hate when it's not obvious why this, no, it does more, so probably this, or does it not, oh no, it did not more. I'm slightly irritated why. Package in. Our best friend. Maybe I also should. Does it work with space or not? Probably, huh? There was some not enough scrollback. Come on, come mix this up. Syntax error near CXXAVI. Okay, maybe it doesn't want space. Also, I'm typo. You add a space and insert a typo. We don't see this in the log because it's using the CXX. It's using the CXX wrapper for the C wrapper for tests. So probably this was working all the time. All right. Conditional arg stuff here. So what is in the issue? Core dumped. CMake. Uncored exception not yet implemented. Okay, then CMake. Okay, so CMake. Core dumps because of an uncored exception, like we could have seen earlier already to start with. So much to who can read, but then it started while we were tinkering on this on libcxx. Wait a second, why do I only add here for cross builds libcxx abi libcxx? Maybe we should always add this? Or can it auto determine that? All this tricky configuration becomes a little bit tricky. Should we try what happened on a... It's really a little bit unfortunate that we broke it like this. If we broke it. It's the only way to your own Linux distribution, and we probably in 2019 don't want to start another one. I mean, it's doing something. The feeling we somehow broke something generically, that we get an uncored exception all over the place. Somehow that doesn't really quite look quite right. Obviously, it would really be nice if it would print the uncored exception or something. Anyway, that is exactly the small detail that I meant that we still need to do. Invalid summary version. Yeah, that could also be now that... actually, maybe let's disable link time optimization. The cross compiler probably not rebuild. Again, this is here operating on a live patient user config LTO that you don't try at home and only occurs when someone sets up, most likely link time optimization, I guess, that the LLVM linker can't read its own object format from the previous version. Yeah, that's starting to build a little bit. Hey, is that even built cross-compiled? Amazing stuff. Just slightly this, but let's see, maybe this magically fixes something else. Doesn't fix this here though. Found. What the heck? Are you completely kidding me? This is probably this not defaulting to the right. Which one was it even? So maybe this might be here just for testing. Maybe we can remove this sometime soon when we are done with it and have proper configuration, because only later when I did this the last month I found here the default lib standard whatever something. So for those let's try with standard lib. But without this linking stuff, I guess, for now. And then on a new rebuild, we would have to check if that goes away with this default lib standard C++ something. CMake configuration there also doesn't work. What does that mean now? Still passes. File not found. Yep, everything always just works. Wait a second, that was wrong. Ah, it was already. Although, it, anyway, so this doesn't have an effect because it says here, not even using that. Let's see where it tries to pick this up as trace. OpenF or log or something. What? User local include bits, no, it's not there. User include bits that it finds. That user, it looks reasonable, but user. This is not where we have new, do we? It's not trying to open new directly, so it's only iterating these passes. I slightly wonder. Apparently, at least, allegedly, as far as I can see, OVS trace is out filter. Here it's Elstat. Nah, wonderful. Why does it not look in a C++ parse? What the heck is that about? Can't make that up. Which ceiling is it even using? Ceiling plus plus. Why is this not even specifying here? Standard C++ 11. Then it works. Why the heck does it not use its system include parse? So this didn't have an effect anyway. Tlib. Don't really feel like injecting that there now with the C++ SOA wrapper. Which library even was that? ABI, right? Here is... I even specify this already. Let me guess the latest version. So looks like maybe this is why we have this here, for it to find it, and then... it doesn't find it anymore, or what? Running CMake with exactly that parse. It's probably to be finished in yet another day. Yep, that's what I meant with all the bits and pieces and stuff and details and such. Anyway, hope you learned something and enjoyed this. And I don't know, leave me in the comments below what you think about this. And I hope to see you soon for all the next, hopefully more amazing stuff to come. So slightly wonder, did nobody else join? I mean, comment since then, but yeah. Apparently.